And joining us now on the line is SEA Games Organizing Committee spokesperson Jerry Osias. Congratulations are in order, sir, for the successful opening ceremonies.
Thank you so much, Rain. Good morning to you and to your televiewers.
Good morning.
It was a great opening, so we are very happy as part of the organizing committee, and we are happy as a Filipino, and we are happy for our country for that great opening yesterday.
Congratulations also for all who took part in the event. What were the comments from President Duterte and Sultan Hassanal Bolkiah from the opening ceremony?
Well, the President and His Majesty the Sultan were both happy last night. In fact, they decided to stay on even after the end of the program last night. So by our official account, they left around 9:30 or close to 10 p.m. in the evening already. And the program was finished around 8:30, 8:45. So they really had a great time. And they decided to linger on and co-mingle with the delegations present last night.
But of course, attorney, even that had been marred by the controversy with the alleged taped lighting of the cauldron. Is that true? And if so, why was it taped? Do the rules for the hosting of the games and the opening ceremony allow for taped lighting of the cauldron?
Well, definitely the lighting was real. There was, in fact, a lighting ceremony. Senator Manny Pacquiao was, in fact, there, as well as all the people present at the cauldron, at the New Clark City Athletic Stadium in the cauldron complex. The people present were also there, including the light show and fireworks. Last night, there was also a fireworks and a light show for the New Clark City complex. Now, as to the question on the timing or the taping of that ceremony with Senator Pacquiao, we would leave it up to the production crew, the director and the producers of the program, the opening ceremony program, to discuss the details of those two ceremonies, one in the Philippine Arena and the other in New Clark City. They would be in the best position to explain the production and technical considerations, whether or not there was in fact a taping which happened at the cauldron ceremony.
Sure, but of course, you would know the rules. Is it allowed in the rules of hosting the opening ceremony that the lighting of the cauldron be taped?
Yeah, well, assuming it was taped, because I'm not saying whether or not it's in fact taped, assuming it was, there's no express prohibition in the SEAD Federation as to the timing of the lighting.
All right, we've also just received a report, a comment by Davao City Mayor and presidential daughter, of course, Sara Duterte, saying that it seems the opening ceremony presentation was a little bit Manila-centric and less inclusive as she would wish. Would you like to offer a comment on that?
Oh, well, I was there at the opening ceremony. I was present at the Philippine Arena. It was as inclusive as it can be because it featured our traditional culture, traditional dances, even our martial arts, our knees. It was well represented, as well as our various cultures all over the region. I think what was posted, attributed to Mayor Sara Duterte, was the choice of the Manila song in the welcome march for the Philippine delegation. Well, because that song was representative of Manila as the capital of the Philippines, no one is disputing that. In fact, it's representative of our country because when you talk about Manila as the capital, you're talking about the Philippines. So when we welcome someone in Manila, it means you're welcoming everyone to the Philippines. So that's my opinion on that. I wouldn't want to hazard a guess on the feelings or sentiments of the presidential daughter. But I, for one, I'm not from Manila. I'm from Las Piñas and my family's from Bulacan. But I did not feel slighted or offended with the choice of the Manila song when it came to the march of our Philippine delegation athletes.
Let's see. Now, 55,000 seats available at the Philippine Arena for the largest indoor opening event. Was it a ticketed event, and who were present apart from the athletes and delegates? Of course, in attendance were about half of the SEA Games delegates, around roughly 5,500. Now, while all 11 countries were represented, some athletes were sad that they couldn't attend because the sports events were so spread out across Luzon they couldn't afford the travel time. Did we also make considerations for these athletes and delegates?
Yes, in fact, the schedule of the opening ceremony was agreed with all 11 countries. It was planned. It's just that some athletes have early games the following morning, which is today. We have triathlon events, we have dance sport events, sepak takraw events. So as a matter of consideration for athletes, they would have to defer to their coaches whether or not they are required to attend in the opening ceremonies. It's a given practice and it's allowed. If an athlete will be told by the coach or by the trainer to just sit it out for today in order to be strong or rejuvenated for the tournament the following day, then that is within the prerogative of the respective teams of the SEA Games.